沉默。 Amen and amen. Our God is worthy to be praised. Our God is awesome and our God is magnificent. He's great and greatly to be praised. We thank him, we bless him, we exalt him. You are once again welcome to Fresh Fire Prayer Ministry, where we keep the fire of the Holy Spirit burning. Today is the day the Lord has made. We'll rejoice and be glad in it. We thank God for the gift of life. We thank God for the gift of health. We thank God for preservation and protection. We thank God for being our sustainer and our deliverer. We give him all the praise and all the honor and all the adoration. For only God deserves to be praised. We thank him for how far he's brought us this year. And we thank him for fighting our battles for us. It doesn't matter what you are going through. Always remember that all things, whether good, bad, or ugly, they are all working together for your ultimate good. God is working everything in our lives for our ultimate good as long as we commit our lives to him, submit his will, seek his face daily. All things will work in your favor in Jesus' name. God is in control. God is still in control over our lives. In the name of Jesus Christ, I want to encourage you to keep on fixing your gaze, your eyes on Christ. And the Bible says, those who put their trust in God, they will never be put to shame. Today is our 10th day of our 21 days fasting and prayer. May the Lord strengthen you as you fast. May the Lord nourish you, empower you to continue. And above all, may the Lord answer your prayers. May the Lord answer your prayers. The reason for fasting is also to seek the face of God concerning issues in our lives. It's my prayer that the Lord will grant you your heart desire. Your fasting will not be in vain. That whatever you are trusting God for, believing God for, the Lord will grant it to you and give you that testimony that you are believing him for in the name of Jesus. He is good, and his goodness and his mercies endure forever and ever in Jesus' mighty name. Before we start, I just want us to spend 5 minutes to just thank him and worship him. Just thank God even in advance for whatever you are believing him for during this season of fasting and prayer. For there is something about worship. God inhabits the praise and worship of his children. The easiest way you can bring God's presence into your battle, into your situation, is to worship him. The Bible says Paul and Silas were bound in prison, and when they started singing hymns and praying, the power of God, the presence of God came, shook the foundation of their prison, chains were broken, the gates were open, and there was great deliverance. I want you to begin to thank God, and I want you to thank God that your requests have been granted, that he has brought you out of that pit, that troubles, that challenges you are going through. Thank him that he has provided your needs. Thank him for restoring your marriage. Thank him for healing your body. Thank him for bringing back your peace, your joy. Whatever you are about to ask today, whatever you are trusting God for, I want you to begin to thank God in faith that it is done. So, Father, I thank you that you are God who answers prayer. You are a mountain mover, a Red Sea divider. You are the God who turns and changes times and seasons. With you, nothing is impossible. With you, all things are possible. I thank you for the breakthrough. I thank you for the miracle jobs. I thank you for the deliverance. I thank you for the healing. I thank you for bringing back my husband. I thank you for touching my son or daughter. I thank you for the great deliverance. I thank you, O Lord, for being my salvation, my rock, my shield, my supporter, my defender, my advocate, my help in times of need. Lord, I thank you for the miracles, the breakthroughs, the restoration, the restitution, helping me to possess my possession. Thank you, Lord Almighty, for the blessings. Begin to just thank God. Just thank God in the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you.
Is in this house tonight.
We worship you, Jesus.
And it's all because of him.
We worship you, Jesus. 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 Thank you, Lord, for being our deliverer. Thank you, Lord, for being our strength. Thank you for being our rock, our fortress, our shield, our defender, our refuge. Thank you, Lord Almighty, for lowering chain shackles. Thank you for opening doors for people. Thank you for supernatural intervention in the situation. Thank you for supernatural intervention in the situation. We worship you, Jesus.
We love you. Jesus. Amen.
Hallelujah.
The Lord God Almighty deserves all the praise. He alone is worthy. 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 God, you are worthy to receive all the praise, to receive all the honor, to receive all adoration. You are the God who is able to do the impossible, an expert in the impossibilities. So we thank you, we bless you, we declare and decree that you are God, you are Lord, and that you are making a way for us where there seems to be no way. Thank you for breakthroughs. Thank you for healings. Thank you for deliverance. Thank you for restoration. Thank you for abundance. Thank you for open doors. Thank you for open gates. Thank you, Lord, for opening the windows of heaven and pouring your blessing. Thank you for divine visitation. Thank you for divine intervention in our situation. Thank you for turning situation in our favor. Thank you for undoing the impossible. Somebody, God, is going to reverse the irreversible, change the unchangeable, and do something miraculous in your situation, because he's an expert in impossibility. When he intervenes, when he visits you, he makes all things beautiful. Father, we thank you that before the end of this week, we will have a cause to say, thank you, Jesus. Ebenezer, that's far, how far you brought us. You've come through for us. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you for marital restorations. We thank you for healings of our bodies from sickness and disease and infirmities. We thank you that the power of witchcraft and demonic attacks on our lives are broken. We thank you that you have delivered us from hidden curses and hidden covenants, that the covenant against us are broken because you have redeemed us from by the blood of Jesus. Thank you that affliction will not return back again. Thank you that today every attack of the enemy over our lives are destroyed. Thank you for our liberty. Thank you for our emancipation. Thank you for our freedom. Thank you, Lord Almighty, for our liberation. We worship you, Jesus, for visiting us and doing a marvelous work in our lives. Thank you for the miracles. Thank you for the supernatural. Thank you, Lord. Amen and amen and amen. God is an expert in impossibility. God is an expert in the impossibility. And what is impossible with man is possible with our God. What looks impossible, what looks hopeless with man is easy, very easy with our God. So I came to prophesy to somebody that whatever situation you are experiencing, facing, challenges you are going through, God is going to turn situations around in Jesus' name. Psalms 126 says, when the Lord turned again the captivity of Zion, whereas though men who were dreaming, when the Lord turned again, when the Lord restored back our captivity. Today, whatever situation you are going through, the Lord is turning it around. God is turning things. Things are turning around. Things are turning. I want somebody to prophesy. Things are turning around for my good. Things are turning around for my good. I want you to say it seven times. Things are turning around for my good. 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 If you are in a place you can move around, I want you to stand up and do this prophetic direction. Turn yourself around and prophesy it three times that things are turning around. You turn around, you turn around, you turn around, you turn around. Things are turning around. Things are turning around. I want you to turn yourself around three times. And as you do it, prophetically declare and decree that things are turning around. Situations are turning around. My marriage is turning around. My finances is turning around. My challenge, the exams and the interview is going to turn around for my good. Whatever you are going through, just turn yourself around three times and declare and decree that things are turning around. Things are turning around. Things are turning around. If you can type it, things are turning around for my good. In the name of Jesus Christ. And you see how things will turn around. it will seem to you as a dream, because God is an expert in impossibility. Things are turning. Things are turning. Things are turning around. Amen. Tonight, we've been dealing with restoration because of Jubilee. And as part of God's restoration program for his children, he begins to attack the attacker and take captives, those who have taken us captive, and bring deliverance to us. So in restoration season, God had to rebuke Pharaoh, plague him, and bring deliverance. So as much as you are experiencing your Jubilee, there's also warfare against your enemies. God is avenging, God is fighting on your behalf. If you read Joel chapter 2, verse 25, Joel chapter 2, verse 25, open your Bibles with me, and let's go to Joel chapter 2, verse 25. Joel chapter 2, verse 25. I will restore to you the years that the locusts have eaten. I will restore. I will restore. I will restore. I want you to declare, Heavenly Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, during this season of Jubilee, during this time of my fasting and prayer, I ask you, in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, my Lord and Savior, I ask you to restore my wasted years. Wasted blessings. Restore, oh Lord, my wasted years and my wasted blessings. In the name of Jesus, I will restore. And God is bringing restoration. When the Lord restores you, suddenly you will experience a supernatural visitation. Suddenly, something you've been trying and attempting to do for so long and failed, you begin to achieve your dreams and vision. Suddenly, prayers begin to be answered. Suddenly, doors begin to open. Suddenly, chains, yokes, and curses are broken. Suddenly, divine helper shows up to come and help you, because God has visited you with restoration. I will restore you the years that the locusts have eaten. So locusts, they come to eat our harvest. They come to eat our fruits of our labor. They come to eat our blessings and destinies. And then we looked at cankerworm yesterday. They also come to feed and destroy our blessings and glories and destiny. And the Lord says, not only will I restore what the locusts have eaten, restore what the cankerworm have also devoured and destroyed in your life, but I move further to also likewise restore what the caterpillar, say caterpillar.
Caterpillar.
The years.
The years.
That the caterpillar.
That the caterpillar.
Has eaten
and devoured,
wasted
in my life,
will be restored. So God says, I will also restore the years that the caterpillar has devoured. So the question is that, what is a caterpillar? How does this caterpillar demon or witchcraft or stronghold fight our lives? Now listen to this and listen to it carefully. The spirit of the caterpillar and its influence and impact in the life of a child of God, and why today the Lord is bringing you deliverance. This week, take it seriously, and all you got to do is to believe God and let God do all the deliverance for you by faith. The Bible says, I will restore the years that the locusts have eaten, the cankerworm have eaten, and the caterpillar. The caterpillar is the larva stage, the larva stage of the butterfly. It is a worm-like It has a worm-like body. It has a what? Worm-like body, which later turns into butterfly. The caterpillar is ugly, but when it turns into butterfly, it is beautiful. So when you are in the caterpillar stage, you are in the ugly stage in your marriage, ugly stage of your finances, ugly stage of your destiny. But when God is about to visit you, he turns you from that caterpillar stage into the butterfly. But demons and witchcraft and evil spirits will want you to remain in that caterpillar cycle, that caterpillar stage of ugliness, of shame, reproach, and disgrace, humiliation, delay, stagnation, singleness, barrenness, and lack of purpose and destiny. The caterpillar is ugly. It is the worm-like, it has a worm-like body. But it is a stage that must also metamorphosize into butterfly. But the devil and witches will keep you there. The ugly stage. This monitoring demon blocks people's destiny and dreams from manifesting. They block your dreams, visions, blessings, prophecies from manifesting. And you keep on hoping and desiring to see the butterfly stage of your marriage, the butterfly stage of your education, the butterfly stage of your life, and caterpillar will keep you in that worm-like state. They cover the stars of people so as to keep them from shining. A caterpillar, the worm-like stage, is not beautiful. It's not attractive. It's not something that people desire. They hinder people from manifesting their glory. They turn princes into slaves. There's a place whereby even they can take you, instead of caterpillar to butterfly, these caterpillar witchcraft, caterpillar demons, and household wickedness can take a butterfly and turn them back into the caterpillar. Haven't you seen people who said, I used to be this, I used to have a house, I used to have a good job, I used to have this amount of savings, I used to do this, and I was having this, and today look at my life. Meaning that the devil took them from a butterfly stage of glory, a butterfly stage of honor, a butterfly stage of prestige, a butterfly stage of relevance, a butterfly stage of enviness, and reduced them into a caterpillar, a worm-like, a nobody, from somebody to nobody, from glory to shame. They turn princes into slaves and rich people into poor men. They turn potential wives into single ladies and fruitful women into barren women. People who should have been employers of labor are reduced to be unemployed. They turn people's destiny upside down and reverse the destinies of men. People with a potential of becoming a beautiful butterfly with different colors. Butterfly has different beautiful colors, attractive. But they will take you and put you in that worm-like state, that lovey state, that undesiring state of caterpillar. Say, Heavenly Father,
Heavenly Father,
in the name of Jesus,
in the name of Jesus,
during this fasting,
doing this fast
and prayer.
And prayer.
Turn me
from a caterpillar
into a butterfly.
Turn my destiny
from a caterpillar into a butterfly.
Into a butterfly.
Let my shame be turned into glory. Read Psalms 4, verse 2. This monitoring demon is also responsible. We'll come to that. Ask yourself, what stage are you in your life right now? What stage? Are you in the butterfly stage, flying with your beautiful marriage and beautiful family and beautiful life? Or you are still in the larvae worm-like caterpillar stage? Undesirable, rejection, disappointment, unfruitfulness, barrenness, stagnation, setbacks, sicknesses, affliction.
Psalm 4, verse 2. How long, O you sons of men, will you turn my glory to shame? How long will you love worldliness?
Oh, you sons of men, how long would you turn my glory? How long would you sons of men, you witches and wizards, you evil spirits, you demonic entities, you agent of darkness, you vultures and predators and snakes in my life, how long would you powers from my mother's house and father's house, enemies and envious, jealous adversaries? How long would you turn my glory, my butterfly state? How long will you turn my butterfly, my glory into shame of the caterpillar? How long? Somebody has turned your glory into shame.
And how long would you love worthlessness?
And how long would you love worthlessness?
And wasting. Seek falsehood.
And seek falsehood. Wasting people's glory. They have turned your glory upside down. They have given you caterpillar instead of butterfly. Some of us are walking around, and spiritually, we are in the caterpillar stage. And some people, they have been so deceived that they think it's okay. You are not born to be like this. You are not born to be begging before you can eat. You are not born to begging before you can pay your bills. You are not born to be single forever. You are not born to be barren forever. You are not born to be unemployed. You are not born to be going through this hardship and difficulties and stagnations and delay. Somebody turned your butterfly. Your glory has turned your glory into shame. Your butterfly state into a caterpillar state. But today, by this word of the Lord, I declare, I decree that everyone hearing the sound of my voice, whom the witchcraft in your mother's house, the witchcraft in your father's house, any demonic altars, satanic covens have turned your glory into shame, I pray for you today, but by the oracle of Jehovah, may the Lord turn your glory, your shame into glory. Say, Heavenly Father,
in the name of Jesus.
Turn my shame into glory. In Jesus' name. You better believe. People are coming on the prayer line and we are praying and declaring. They don't believe. They will still be thinking about the past. So whilst we are experiencing deliverance by the words of our mouth and by our faith and our declaration, some people are still languishing in their bondage because they don't believe that life and death lies in the power of the tongue. And by faith, you can move mountains. People are still rehearsing who they used to be. When God is telling you that I'm turning your shame into glory, your caterpillar into butterfly, people are still, but what about, I used to be this, I used to go through this, you have to have a spirit husband, which is, please, we are moving forward with the word of God. The word of God says, he's turning my shame into glory. This is what I believe. This is what I believe. I receive it and I'm moving forward. For the Bible says that so shall be my word that proceeded from out of my mouth. It will not return unto me void. This word I'm pronouncing, I'm declaring, I'm decreeing, I'm commanding it to your life. As many as are receiving it in faith, God is turning you from a caterpillar into a butterfly. God is turning your shame, your misery into glory. In the name of Jesus, so shall it be. How long? How long would you, sons of men? It saddens me. It saddens me. It saddens me that people come on and they hear the word of the Lord and it doesn't profit them because of unbelief. It saddens me. And yes, still we have people who hear just ordinary nice sermons and are being transformed. And here are people fasting, praying, and yes, they will hear the word of the Lord. But because of unbelief, lack of faith, they were not benefiting. For the Bible says that they heard the word of God as we also heard. But because they did not mix the word of God with faith, it did not profit them. Some people have been following this ministry for 5 years, 6 years. It is not profiting them because they come on and are very religious and are always on, but don't have faith to believe the word of God to transform them. Then somebody will hear about us, watch us, and then come on 1 day, 2 days, and then they have their breakthrough, their miracle, because they are desperate for the word of God and they believe. For the Bible says that the kingdom of our God suffered violence and the violent take it by force. I pray that somebody will believe that God in this season of Jubilee, in these 21 days, is turning people's shame into glory. People's caterpillar cycle, caterpillar's patterns in your life, challenges in your life, into a butterfly state. Believe and receive it in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
This monitoring demon is also responsible for inversely proportional problems. Inversely, let me explain to you what it means. This means that for any blessing or breakthrough you have, so supposing you are believing God for a breakthrough of $10,000, $5,000, or let's use $5,000. So you get that $5,000 and you are so happy, you are so thankful. The demon of caterpillar, witchcraft of caterpillar, will cause you to have a 10,000 or 15,000 problem or debt that will negate that 5,000 breakthrough you had. So for every blessing that comes your way, it will bring a greater dimension of a problem to swallow up that breakthrough you had. Every time you have a breakthrough, a bigger problem will come and cancel out a bigger problem. So you get the money and you say, oh, thank God, finally I've gotten $5,000 to be able to fulfill my dreams and vision. The next minute you have a 10,000 worth of issue problem that comes in to use the 10,000, and then you are even owing 5,000. And for every time you have any joy or any level of breakthrough, a greater dimension of problem will come and hit you and swallow up all your blessings. This is what is causing people to always find themselves in ground zero, because not because they haven't received breakthroughs, not because they haven't seen some level of success, but every time they get any level of breakthrough, a greater dimension of an attack will happen. Like Job, suddenly Job began to have problems upon problems upon problems. So much that the man who was the richest man in the East, within a few days, he had lost everything and he had been reduced into impoverishment. Poverty had taken over. I pray for you that today, every caterpillar spirit every caterpillar demon that is working in your life, let that spirit die. Let that spirit die. Any cycle of caterpillar in your life, I break that cycle of your life. In the name of Jesus, let that cycle be broken. Whatever denies you your blessing, whatever denies you your glory, whatever denies you your access into your open door, whatever has caused you to remain in this state of caterpillar for so long you can't get married, for so long you can't get pregnant, for so long you can't graduate, from so long you can't get a job, for so long you can't enjoy your marriage, for so long you can't express joy and peace and liberty, whatever's kept you in that caterpillar state, today I command that caterpillar cycle to be broken. Say, be broken.
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 In Jesus' name, let the caterpillar cycle in your life, in my life, be broken. And in the name that is above every name, may the Lord God Almighty turn your situation into what? Into glory. How long would you, sons of men, turn my shame, my glory into shame? I want you to do something. You are going to pray. You are going to ask the Lord to turn, Father, turn, Father, turn my caterpillar into butterfly. Turn my shame into glory. And I want you to be on your feet. And just begin to say, in the name of Jesus, Lord, turn my destiny around. Turn me from shame into glory, from caterpillar to butterfly. And turn around as you are praying. If you can turn around, just turn around as you are praying and declare it and decree it and declare it. That as I turn around, whoever has turned my glory into shame, as I am turning around, may the Lord, may the angel of the Lord begin to turn my shame into glory and from my caterpillar into butterfly. Do this prophetic act as you begin to pray right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Stand up on your feet and turn around and say, Father, in the name of Jesus, as I do this prophetic direction, turn my caterpillar into butterfly. Turn my shame into glory in the mighty name of Jesus. Stand up and begin to turn around. Turn around in the name of Jesus. Turn around and declare and decree that, Lord, turn my caterpillar. Turn my caterpillar. Turn my caterpillar. Turn it into butterfly. Turn my shame into glory. Begin to turn around. 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 And command in the name of Jesus. Lord, turn, turn, turn. Turn every caterpillar state. Turn every shameful state in my life into glory. Caterpillar into butterfly. Somebody turn your life around. Turn around. Turn, turn, turn. For the Bible says in Isaiah chapter 26, when the Lord turned again, the captivity of Zion, God is turning. God is breaking evil cycles. God is breaking the cycle. God is breaking the cycle. As you are turning around, God is breaking the cycle. As you are turning around, chains are breaking. As you are turning around, jokes are breaking. As you are turning around, curses are breaking. As you are turning around, something is breaking off your life, from caterpillar into butterfly, from shame into glory, into glory. Turn around in the name of Jesus. Lord, turn, 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 turn. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, turn, Lord, turn, 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 turn my life around from caterpillar into butterfly. Hey, atakarianto zen delebosata, rakata kevetoska, rakapune lesen tunimianta, payande fen tunimianta. Turn around as you prophesy concerning your marriage. Lord, turn my marriage from shame into glory. Turn my finances from shame to glory. Turn my health from shame into glory. Turn, 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 turn. Turn my poverty into riches. Turn my misfortune into divine fortune. Turn my pain into gain. Turn my obstacles into miracle. Turn my caterpillar into butterfly. In the name of Jesus, let there be a supernatural turn around.
upturn my destiny, restore my destiny from shame to glory, from caterpillar to butterfly. Let the power of the caterpillar, witchcraft, demons, curses, foundations be broken of my life. Turn around and prophesy. Lord, turn my son's destiny around. Turn my daughter's destiny around. Turn my husband's destiny around. Turn my wife's destiny around. From caterpillar into butterfly. From caterpillar to butterfly. From caterpillar to butterfly. Let there be a turn. Let there be a turn. Let the power of God break the yoke. Let the power of God break the yoke. As you are turning around, chains are breaking. As you are turning around, the power of God is coming upon you. As you are turning around, the fire of God is coming upon you. As you are turning around, the power of God is breaking the caterpillar cycle. Loose in the name of Jesus. Barrenness into fruitfulness. Unemployment to employment. Crying to joy. Bondage into liberty. Rejection to acceptance. The Lord is bringing you out of caterpillar, bringing you out of shame, and bringing you into the realms of glory. Somebody turn around and prophesy. Prophesy, prophesy, prophesy. I am moving from caterpillar to butterfly. My marriage will express butterfly. My destiny will express butterfly. I will begin to manifest the glory. I will begin to manifest the glory. I am breaking out. I'm breaking loose. I am moving higher. I'm moving higher. I am moving higher. In the name of Jesus, I cannot remain a worm anymore. I cannot remain a worm anymore. I am moving from the caterpillar into butterfly. I will fly. Spread my wings. With beauty and honor, with dignity, with relevance, with the blessings of God. May the power of God touch you right now. Let the yoke of the caterpillar, let the spells of the caterpillar, let the cycle of the caterpillar over your life be broken now. In the name of Jesus. The power of God is coming upon people right now. The power of God is touching you right now. As you are turning around, I see the power of God. I see the power of God. I see the power of God breaking something is loose in your life. Your destiny will never be the same. No more will you struggle to get a job. No more will you struggle to pay your bills. No more will you struggle to sleep anymore. No more will they turn your glory into shame. Today, whoever turned your glory into shame, God is reversing. God is reversing. And turning your shame into glory. Turning your shame into glory. Your curse into blessing. Your pain into gain. Your obstacles into miracles. Your misfortune to divine fortune. In the name of Jesus. Caterpillar to butterfly. Caterpillar to butterfly. Caterpillar to butterfly. Caterpillar to butterfly. It is done. It is done. It is done. It is simple as that. It is done. People, the word of God is coming. Prophetic word of God is coming for transformation. People, open up your heart. Believe and receive it in Jesus' name. So you can have a testimony. People are having testimony every day. And it saddens me that those who just came yesterday are those who are grabbing their testimonies. And we have people just watching and being religious. Believe. We are not here for games. We are here for signs. Wonders, miracles. Today, your life will never be the same. In Jesus' name, take your communion. Father, we thank you that today there has been a spiritual metamorphosis. Today, there has been a spiritual metamorphosis, a spiritual shift, and a spiritual transformation. Father, we thank you that you have moved us from the cycle of the lover, of the caterpillar into the realms of the butterfly. You have moved us from the realms of shame, reproach, disgrace, humiliation, bondage, affliction, slavery into the realms of liberty and glory. Thank you that the blood of Jesus Christ has redeemed us from the caterpillar into butterfly, from shame into glory. As we drink this, let your word manifest physically in our lives. With supernatural breakthroughs, signs, and wonders. In Jesus' name. We call it done. Amen. Amen. The year is coming to an end. We don't have time for unbelievers. We only have time for believers who will believe the word of God and break out and break through. Today, something has broken out loose of your life. You will begin to express the glory in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Join us every day. We are on the tenth day of our 21 days fasting. 10th day of our 21 days fasting and prayer. I encourage you to join us every day from 6 a.m. in the morning to 6 p.m. in the evening. 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. is the fasting time. And we fast and we meet. We break the fast at 6 p.m. and we eat. And then we meet in the evening at 11 p.m. Eastern Time U.S. 11 p.m. Eastern Time U.S. For those of you in London, it will be 4 a.m. For those of you in Europe, it will be 5 a.m. You join us through our YouTube platform, KL Blessing. Subscribe to our KL Blessing YouTube channel and also our Fresh Fire Prayer Line YouTube channel, and follow us on Facebook, KL Blessing. KL Blessing, and join us every evening at 11 p.m. Eastern Time, 4 a.m. London, 5 a.m. through these channels, and your life will never be the same. For further information, go to our website, www.freshfireprayer.com, www.freshfireprayer.com, and you'll get all the information about the ministry. You can also purchase our deliverance materials and warfare prayer books through the ebook and Kindles through our website, www.freshfireprayer.com. You can also send your donation, your sacrifice for the hidden curses, and also Jubilee sacrifice through the website, www.freshfireprayer.com, through Cash App. The Cash App is Fresh Fire Prayer. Fresh Fire Prayer. The number for the Zelle is on our website. The address for the church is also on our website. Just go to the website and you get all these medium of donation and books and resources on our website, www.freshfireprayer.com. Amen and amen. I believe that today, as you were turning around, something was shifting. Something was shifting. Something was changing. There was a spiritual metamorphosis. God was shifting you from the caterpillar into the butterfly in the name of Jesus, from shame into glory. Whoever turned your shame, your glory into shame, the Lord has reversed it back. You will begin to have good dreams. Some of you were having very evil, satanic, demonic dreams representing shame, reproach, disgrace, humiliation. By this prophetic direction that you just went and turned yourself around, you will not have those evil dreams again. Whatever they did to you to put you in the state of shame, reproach, and disgrace, it has been broken in the name of Jesus Christ. If you have been having such dreams, after this also, anoint yourself. Anoint yourself before you sleep. You will see the glory of God in your life. It is done. It is done. It is done. I encourage people to believe. I encourage people to believe. We don't have time for. I don't have time for unbelief. Unbelief will just set you back. Unbelief will keep you in bondage. Unbelief doesn't help anybody. Believe what God has done today and begin to fly. And begin to see the butterfly flying, flapping its wings with beauty. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen and amen. Tomorrow, what we are reading, what? Romans chapter 16. That will be the last chapter, Romans chapter 16. Join us as we read Romans chapter 16 tomorrow. Romans chapter 16 tomorrow. May the Lord God Almighty turn your shame into glory and also your caterpillar state. Some of you have been in that caterpillar state for a long time. Singleness, unemployment, barrenness, pain, bondage. Today the cycle is broken. From today, you will begin to see breakthroughs, favors, open doors, deliverance, good dreams, liberty, relationships working, marriage working, financial opportunities. You beginning to see your dreams and visions coming to pass because you are no more. Don't come into... Please, please. Why should God bring you into the place of butterfly? And the butterfly is still thinking like a caterpillar. Renew your mind. You are no more a caterpillar. That's my problem. Somebody, God has turned you into a butterfly. God has transitioned you from shame into glory. Why should a person who is now a butterfly with beautiful wings,
wings, feathers or whatever it is, wings to fly with beauty and honor, still be having the caterpillar mindset because of unbelief, looking at their past of what the caterpillars they did to them. Please, I've moved on. Move on. Move on. Move on in the name of Jesus Christ. Renew your mind and know that the past is over. God is doing a new thing from today. You are no more the past. You are no more a caterpillar. You are a butterfly. You are no more in shame realm. You are in the realms of glory. And let the glory of God visit you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Shalom. Peace be unto you. And we will see you tomorrow. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.